This episode is sponsored by
Chairman's Custard Creams. They're tasty.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And today we're going to be having a look at this. This is the Highland Railway Jones Goods 460, bought to Train Simulator 2020 by Caledonia Works. So what is the Jones Goods? Well, you probably recognise it, even if you don't think you do. So, they were designed by David Jones for the Highland Railway in 1894, and there were 15 of them built by Sharp Stewart and Company. They were, the most interesting thing about them is that they were the very first class of 460 built in the British Isles and to operate in the British Isles. So it's kind of interesting there because the preserved one, number 103, is also the very first one of the type built. So the very, very first 460 ever to operate in this country, in the UK, is actually preserved, and we'll talk a bit more about 103 later on. So they were designed for goods work. They worked on the Highland Railway until being absorbed into the LMS in 1923, where they were all renumbered into a block and they were given the classification 4F, which is kind of interesting because they've got 5'3" drivers, which makes them kind of quite powerful but speedy too. So when they were to the LMS, they were all painted black. I think some of them were lined out, some weren't, and they were all withdrawn and gone by 1940, just as World War II was operating. I don't know why I said operating, but I'm going to leave that in because it's funny and different. So the only one of the type that survived was number 103. This was preserved, and basically it ran some rail tours for British Railways in the 1950s and early 60s, and it was repainted from its LMS livery back into Highland Railway yellow like this. But there are some slight differences, which I'll show you on the model later, because this is the default one, because this livery here was only worn by the locomotives for a short amount of time before they were repainted into a more green livery, as you can see next to us here. So number 103 did some rail tours. It starred in the film, well, I say starred, it was in the film Those Magnificent Men in Their Flying Machines as a sort of cameo. I think it was filmed to be just a generic train that they were riding behind or whichever. I've never seen the film, I don't know. But it was withdrawn by British Railways in 1966, and it is now preserved at the Glasgow Riverside Museum up in Scotland, along with some other locos of Scottish heritage. The 103 was actually one of the engines. There was four of them. I can't remember all of them, but I know 123 and the other one was Gordon Highlander. I can never remember the other one. I want to say a Ben class, but I don't think a Ben class is preserved. I'll have to look up on that one. But it was one of the four locomotives that were of, you know, an ancient, no, I say ancient, you know, an elderly pedigree that was brought out by the Scottish Operating Department, and they ran some rail tours. So kind of nice to see that they were interested in their heritage. So that's probably the best take I'm going to have on the history of the Jones Goods. It's a shame, really, because as I said earlier, there's only one Highland Railway locomotive preserved at all, and that is 103, and it doesn't operate. So we've gone through the history. Let's have a look at the model and have a look at the liveries that are included. So as you can see here, we have the Highland Railway, Stroudley engine green, basically, I think it is, which is essentially banana yellow. So this is now Chris Rasmussen's favourite logo. And what can I say? The thing is with this logo, which I have to give Chris some credit for, is that he's been using substance painter and getting used to it. And because of these liveries being so bright, you can really see where that effort's gone in with the substance painter. For those who don't know what I'm on about, basically it's a texture painting tool which allows sort of realistic grime and all that to build up in places where it would be difficult to clean. So for example, right here on the buffers and in the little nooks and crannies along the locomotive. So that's why it doesn't look pristine. And actually, do you know what? I think I prefer that. It makes it look more workaday. It makes it look a bit more realistic, I suppose. So, you know, in the texture department, Chris is right up there. So you may have noticed as well on the model, only one variant of this loco has a different one, but they all have this very odd chimney. Now, I'm not a big fan of the look of the chimney, and we can all speculate all day long as for what the louvres were for. I think that's how you pronounce it, louvres or louvers, up in the chimney. Now, My theory is it's for drafting purposes or smoke lifting purposes, as in when the loco's moving forward at speed, air drawn into those little cuts and grooves in the chimney, and that helps to blow steam out of the driver's eye. But it could have been for anything. It could have been for drafting. It could have been for aesthetics. We don't really know. We don't know enough about it, which is kind of interesting. So as we continue along the model, you can see again, we've got more of the grime and dirt that built up, lots of scratches. You can see there the Sharp Stewart & Company builder plate there. You've also got the weird thing about this, and probably the distance in driving wheels. Now, we've worked out why this is, we think, anyway. Because as you can see, the front two coupled driving wheels are very close, and the trailing driving wheel is a little bit further away. Now, we think that's because of the firebox. There needed to be space for the firebox and the dampers and all that, so... Correct me if you think I'm wrong, but I think that's possibly what it is. And as usual, as you can see with the model, there's not really much I can say. Chris knows what I'm on about. His standards are just, you know, he's got very good standards. He builds quickly. He builds engines that look the part. And his technical work is getting better and better every time. And I think this one has slight 3D numbering again, yeah, on the Highland Railway in the middle there. So... I mean, it's very difficult because mainly the only thing that I do dark tries on nowadays is the Caledonia work stuff because unless something else comes out that's a bit special, mainly because I'm trying to do a mate a favour and give him some exposure and whatnot because he is a very talented guy. He's certainly a lot better than I can do. But yeah, keep trying to keep on track anyway and not sound like a massive dick sucker. And also to make sure Chris doesn't say anything about feet in the comment section. Let's move on. The tender. Now, it's a pleasant little tender. It's kind of a generic little tender. But the thing that you might notice is it's got this toolbox on the back. Quite a few of the Caledonia logos we've looked at have this toolbox. But it's a very... In this livery, anyway, it looks very much like a Stroudly sort of tender. I think it technically is Stroudly livery. I'm going to have to be corrected on that if I'm wrong. But... You know what I'm like in these things, guys. I always make mistakes. And that's what everyone looks for. That's why you come here. You come here to tell me, oh, but Tom, you're wrong about X, Y, and Z. Oh, it's got, like, wheels and, you know, bubble baths and all that. So, I don't bloody know. Anyway, as we're looking around here, now, the interesting thing is that on the preserved version of 103, it doesn't have this thing. Now, I'm going to give people 5 seconds to guess what this is. So... 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You've had your time. So, what do you guys think this is? No, it is not a sexual implement. This is a tablet exchange apparatus. So what this does is it allows engines to exchange railway tokens, signaling tokens, so that they can have sections of line. So because most of the railway lines were single track, they needed to be done with tokens and block sections. So... What these things would do is they would be deployed by the driver, they'd hang out, and they'd actually collect a token or drop it off. I believe they can drop it off with these as well. But mainly to pick up, I think. So, it's kind of nice to see a model. It would have been cool if Chris had made it so you could actually have a control value that would allow you to drop the tablet catcher, because that's basically what it is, a tablet catcher. So it would have been cool if that had been implemented, but, you know, at the end of the day, it's not the most important thing. It's just a little aesthetic. There are some other little aesthetics that we've seen. I mean, I've been in with Mr. Chris Rasmussen himself, Epic Banafted, who this is probably a favourite engine now. We've discovered that there's actually a nice, cool little feature. I'll show you on the operation version, but you can see water droplets coming out. So every time Chris builds something new, there always seems to be something different about them, and that gives them character. I think there might even be a Bible in the cab. Yes, there it is. Found it pretty quick. And you can also see that we've got the new driver and fireman asset people. I mean, that's clearly supposed to be Chris, I think. Maybe. And then you got this dude who is clearly a sailor. Popeye. In fact, what's that say on his... Oh, wow, he's actually got a little Highland Railway cap. That's bloody awesome. So, yeah, new driver and fireman model. That's pretty cool. Maybe that is meant to be Chris. I don't know. He'll correct me. I mean, the nose is far too small. Chris's nose is huge. I keep saying Chris. There's lots of Chris's I know. It's really annoying. So, anyway, shall we move on? So, we've got the Highland Railway yellow, or improved engine green, if you like. Next up on my little list of things is this one. Now, this isn't the next in the list. This is bleh. My brain needs to work today. This is Drummond Green, and this is my favourite livery of the lot because I love the red cylinder covers, and I love the fact it's got the Highland Railway decals on the tender, which I think were done by Sam Steventon. I keep getting my words mixed up today. Sorry, everyone. Sam Steventon of Blastpipe Productions, who, as you guys know, I talk to on occasion. He's all right. He's a cool lad. So, as you can see as well, you can really see the grimy bits. And you can, if you come down right down here, you can see all of this on the wheels and stuff. I mean, you know, there's lots of lining and stuff. It's very good. And it's kind of unique looking, especially because of the wheel arrangement. And the fact that it was the first 460, you know, leaves it... There might have been some room for improvement, and let's face it, every other 460 built in the country basically can generate its history back to this loco, so that's pretty good. So of the liveries, I think this one's my favourite, the red running plate, the red cylinder cover, the actual decals on the tender, and yeah, just a very pleasant livery, this one. So there's a couple more, because I want to talk about some features, as you can see over here. So next up on our little thing list of thingies is this one, which is David Jones's apple green version. And as you can see, it's got a giant snow plume. Now, only a couple of the Highland Railway locos have the... Well, the Highland Railway locos, liveries, have this massive snow plough. There is a smaller one you can attach to the LMS liveries, but it's kind of cool to see like one of these big, massive snow ploughs. I'm hoping Chris makes this a child object so we can put it on other locos. But again, this livery is very similar to the other one. I think there's only some minor differences, but it's still quite pleasant to look at, and it's probably my maybe second favourite. And last but not least on the Highland Railway liveries is this sort of, I think it's called Cummings livery, which is never going to not be funny. Sorry to Mr. Cummings, whoever you were, but your surname was very hilarious. Now, I don't like this one, only because I like engines with red buffer beams. It looks very utilitarian, I think I said that properly, in this livery. So, yeah, I mean, it's fine. I just think I would have preferred it with the with like red buffer beams or something. But it looks very southern-y. Like, you know, it looks very much southern olive green. So I figured this is sort of Cummings olive green. And as you can see here as well, from this livery onwards, they stopped with the copper cap chimney. Because I think it was on these ones and then they've taken off these. So that is the Highland Railway liveries. Let's zoom over here and have a look at the LMS ones. So the first one I'm going to look at is actually this, because sorry, my throat is so dry today. This is the fictional livery that's included in the pack, which is probably my second or third favorite of the lot, because I like the LMS black lined as well. And as you can see here, I've put this one down with the miniature snowplow that they come with. You can change that in the scenario editor because, again, you know, this comes with SimNation Locomotion. Not 2.0 yet, but we're getting there. So this is a fictional livery. This is basically, they never wore this passenger livery. I think it was a passenger livery because engines that were lined were... Chris said something about engines that were lined by the LMS were then painted in colour, but these never were. So he's included it as a fictional what if. And I think it's probably one of the best ones of the lot. So it's very, like, easy on the eyes. Anything looks good in red. Next up, we've got the LMS lined black. Yeah, the lined black, which is also quite nice. Probably my third favourite. I don't know. Everything's going to be my third favourite. They're all very cool. And, of course, you know, they give a bit more variety to the class. So it's quite a big pack. Now, here we've got the two unlined black ones. One of them is pre-1928, the other in post. I think this is pre-1928 on this side, and it still has all of the Jones fittings. But if we then move over to the 1928 livery, you can see that the smoke box has been changed, you can see the chimney has been changed, and you can still see that it's got tablet apparatus, and you can also see that the safety valves and whistle are slightly different, and they've been lowered, I think. So overall, that one probably one of my favourite ones because it looks more workaday, I suppose. Looks more like it would have been a bog standard engine. I mean, it lost a little bit of its character because it also lost the wing plates, as you can see here. you know, the Highland Railway wing plates on the smoke box sides. So, and it's probably best here, you can see with the substance paint how it actually gets in and gets where the grime is meant to be and where realistically it would go. So, overall, Highland going good so far? So far, so good. So, I think now we need to go and have a drive with one. Before we do, let's have a scooch over here, because the train we're going to drive is obviously up there, but Chris has also got some new wagons in this. So we've got this, they're in LMS livery, because I'm driving the Jones Goods in its, like, preserved livery, I guess. But you've got this unique-looking brake van, which kind of has a continental feel to it because of the top. They come in, this comes with the pack, and it comes in two liveries. You've got LMS and Highland Railway liveries. So hopefully someone will make a Highland Railway route. We just need some new Highland Railway locos similar to this. Then you've got various four-plank wagons, I think they are, tarped with barrels and coal and all that lot. So, you know, that's kind of good. And then we finally move on to the final livery that we're looking at and the engine that we're going to drive up the Brentwell branch, because I couldn't get this engine to work on a Highland line. So I just wanted to go through some of the differences on the preserved version of 103 rather than the other livery we saw. The first thing to notice is it has the star on the smoke box. Secondly, the copper cap chimney is a lot more polished, as it should be. Thirdly, it's got this very discreet flash warning stickers on it because it was running under the wires. And I think the only thing, other thing I noticed on this livery is the cast Highland Railway plate. So yeah, I think those are the main differences between this version and the other. And the weather looks like it's changing, so I think we better take this for a run. So, next up, let's go and have a look in the cab. So here we are in the cab of the Jones Goods. I just wanted to point out something at this point in time, actually, which is, I know it's going to make me sound like the biggest headed person in the world, but because I did a little bit of testing on this during its development, so I did a little bit of bug testing, I'm actually appearing in the manual as a credit in the beta testing section and the thank you section. So that's really nice to see, because, you know, I do like helping and I do like sort of being there for people. But it's just kind of nice to see my name in an official, you know, product description credit, I guess. And the only reason I'm mentioning coming into the cab is because something I noticed in the beta when I was beta testing it was the gauges up here weren't aligned properly with the textures on the back, and that was fixed. I'd like to think it was fixed because I noticed it. I'd like to think that I helped. So what have you got in the cab? Just to move on so I don't sound like I've got a massive head. Well, we've got Abomination over there. Anyone who gets the joke will understand. We've got a cab Bible, as you definitely need in a Caledonia Works logo. You've got your little flask over here. Got your little box, nice little details here, fully animated cab, quite Spartan compared to the modern day cabs, but soul serves. You've got your brake handle, you've got your regulator there, reverser there, firebox as you can see there, which has got a really weird design. It's got like that grill type design. Maybe it's to help with drafting. Who knows, maybe it could just be that David Jones kind of had a flair for that sort of thing. And we've also got, as I said, the working gauges, and I'm not sure whether the water gauges are working on this one, or even if it... the water gauge is there. I'll have to see. I don't think the water gauge works on this one, but we'll have a look, guys. Not that big a deal, to be honest, but I rarely ever look at it. Animated handbrake there. And you can see that the textures in here, I think, are more, spruced up from the other one, because it's obviously the clean preserved version. So, should we have a look at what cabin we got? I think probably a good idea. So, you got driver side down in the firebox. Still think that's probably one of the best firebox flows and firebox animations we've got so far. You've then got this side of the cab, out the cab window, down by the driving wheels, obviously a good choice. Up near the smoke box, looking back again, front, and then this side as well, and out the cab window there. So what I'm going to do is pull back to the front, because we're going to set up our lamp code. So again, this logo comes with the lamps done by, well, empowered by Sim Nation's Locomotion Script. We've set up a head code because we're going to run a little train. We're going to turn the sounds up and we're probably going to listen to the sounds while we're chuffing along the line. One thing I will note as well is that because the Jones Goods is not running preservation and it's difficult to get sounds for it, this engine doesn't technically have authentic sounds. But they're probably the closest we're going to get. So I think we should all shut our mouths and not complain. Because if something is not running preservation, we can't get realistic sounds for it. So they're close enough. And they're pretty good anyway, so I'm not too worried. That was something. I'm going to show you the dripping of the... it should be water droplets. There you go, you can see them there. Coming out where the injector pipes are. So that's kind of a nice little touch. So without further ado, let's couple up to our train. And then I'll turn the sounds up. We'll have a listen to the Jones Goods and it whistles and it chuffs. And then we'll, I don't know how far we'll go, but we'll go up the line. And we will see. So without further ado, let's get those sounds up. If I can find my sound volume mixer. Let's do this.
Thank you.
them birds. So we'll go up the top of the hill, go down the other side, and then I'll call it a day there, I think, because, I mean, look at it, listen to it, it's pretty cool, isn't it? There, but you can also see the particle change when you stop firing. So for example, you see at the moment the smoke is white. If I open the firebox here and then start firing again, it will go black. There we go. So I think I'll leave it there as we cross this viaduct at Mission Hill. So that was the, if I get the camera right, that was the Jones Goods for Train Simulator 2020. So I'd like to thank Chris Wilson for sending it over. And I think he's done a good job. So the rest of the team. So if you want to pick up the, when the wagons are finished, if you'd like to pick up the Jones Goods, it's available on Caledonia Works' website. And I hope you enjoyed the video. And I will see you all next time. Goodbye.